And we have Lulu in the house today. Come here. I'm gonna start down on our backs. Knees into your chest, give yourself a squeeze. Hi, Lulu. Good, let the knees drop a little wider. Bring the big toes toward each other. Lulu always sounds like she's angry, and it's just the same voice she has when she's happy or mad. Good, slide your elbows to your knees, and then isometric, push the elbows and knees against each other. Press the big toes together. Neutral, well, not really neutral, because you're in a really deep hip flexion here, but you're not curling the shoulders off the ground quite yet, in case you're wondering. Head is down. Broaden across the chest. You're gonna take an inhale. Now, exhale. Slide the arms up. Bring the triceps to the knee. And then inhale, control it back down. Exhale, press it up. And then bring it back down with your inhale. A few more like that. Exhaling up. And inhaling down. And if you couldn't guess, we're making shapes here. This is Bakasana on your back. One more time. We're going to hold this one up. Take a few breaths here. And then push your legs forward. Rise up into boat pose. Legs can be bent or straight. You decide. Yes, very nice. And then cross at your shins. Downward facing dog, please. Pause in down dog, plant your hands fully into the ground. Stretch the heels back, lift the hip creases high. Gently press the chest toward the legs. Lift all of your toes up, dig the base of the big toe into the ground. The base of the pinky toe into the ground and start to press the heels down a little heavier. And then toes come back down and give your toes some energy. Inhale, glide forward to plank. And downward facing dog with your exhale. Inhale, forward to plank. And downward facing dog, exhale. One more time, inhale, forward to plank. And then this time, lower down to your belly. Stretch the arms back, stretch the feet back, Shalabhasana, palms face in toward each other. Take another inhale, hands come down, tuck the toes, press up to plank, and downward facing dog. Right knee to your chest, place your right foot forward. Good. Heart pulls forward, inhale. Exhale, straighten the front leg. Inhale, heart pulls forward. And then exhale, straighten. Inhale. Exhale. Two more, inhale. And exhale. One more, inhale. Exhale. Soften the front knee. Step back to plank, inhale. To the floor, exhale. Shalabhasana again. So working those back muscles. So this is a more engaged back bend than say cobra and upward facing dog, because we're actually pulling away from the ground. We're pulling away from gravity without the help of our feet and hands to get us up. Hands at the ribs, tuck the toes, downward facing dog. Take a breath in, and then left foot steps forward. Inhale, heart pulls forward, hips sink a bit, and then exhale, pressing back. Inhale, draw forward, and exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more time, inhaling forward. And then exhaling. Soften the front knee, step back to plank. Lower down, floor. Shalabhasana, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. High to your toes, inhale. Bend your knees, look forward, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Rise, inhale. And bring your hands into your heart, exhale. Inhale, reach up, rise up from the heart. Use your glutes, little mini back bend on the top. Forward fold, exhale. Halfway, inhale. Fold back down, exhale. Push into your feet. Use your legs, squeeze your glutes. Rise all the way up to stand, little mini back bend. And hands into your heart, exhale. So good, we do that again. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, bow. Inhale, halfway. And fold, exhale. Use your legs. Squeeze your glutes. Pull the belly up and back. Lift the heart to the sky. Draw the hands into your heart. Last half salute. Inhale, rise. Beautiful. Exhale and bow. Halfway inhale. And then fold down. Exhale. Rise up. Inhale. And draw your hands into your heart. Exhale. Inhale. Rise up. Exhale. Forward fold. Halfway inhale. Right foot steps back. Crescent pose, rise up. Release your hands down to the ground. Step back to plank, inhale. Exhale to the floor again. Cobra, inhale, push the feet down. And then with the hands, just feel, it's a bigger back bend, right? Downward facing dog, because you get the help of the arms. And you probably feel like your back does a lot less work, right? Right foot steps forward. High on the left toes, crescent, inhale. And then bring your hands top of the mat. Bring your feet to the top of the mat. Come halfway with your inhale. Fold down, exhale. Strong legs, rise. Use your glutes. Lift your heart. And then fold right back down again, exhale. Halfway, inhale. Left foot steps back. Rise up. Crescent pose. Release your hands down. Inhale, plank to the ground. Exhale. Cobra, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Left foot steps forward. Crescent pose, inhale. Top of the mat, hands and feet, forward fold. Halfway, inhale. And then fold down. Rise up, inhale. And this time, bring your hands into your heart. Inhale, rising up. Exhale, bowing forward. Halfway up, inhale. Right leg stretches back. And then fold in standing splits. Couple breaths here. Start to bend the left leg, step the right foot back, crescent pose, inhale. And then release your hands down to the ground. Step to plank, lower chaturanga or the floor, cobra or up dog. And down dog, exhale. Right foot steps forward. Good, rise to crescent, please. And then standing splits. Couple breaths. And then feet together, top of the mat. Halfway inhale. And fold. Rise up. Use your butts. Lift the heart. Strong, strong, strong. Fold right back down. Exhale. Inhale, halfway. Left foot steps back. I'm sorry, stretches back. And then melt down standing splits. Bend your standing leg. Step your left foot back. Crescent. Inhale. Release your hands down. Step to plank. Lower down chaturanga or the floor. Up dog or cobra. Or shalabhasana. Any one of those back bends is great. And then down dog. Beautiful. Good. Little pause here. Left foot steps forward. Rise up. Crescent. And then standing splits. Bring your feet together. Halfway inhale. And fold, exhale. Rise up, inhale. And bring your hands into your heart, exhale. Good. Inhale, circle, rise up. Exhale, bow forward. Halfway, inhale. Take it back, chaturanga. To the ground, whatever works. Good. Glory, I hope it's good now. Hope I'm not too blurry. Inhale, lift your heels. Bend your knees, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Rise, inhale. Use your hips, lift, lift, lift. Fold right back down with your exhale. Halfway, inhale. Take it back, Vinyasa. You can skip every single one. So you don't ever have to do chaturanga unless you want. There's lots of variations you've been offered. Exercise your options. Lift your heels, inhale. Bend your knees, feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. And then fold. Rise, inhale. Use your butt, lift your heart. Stretch the fingers up. And bow right back down, exhale. Halfway inhale, chaturanga, exhale. Rise, up dog, cobra, and dog, exhale. Rise to your toes, bend your knees, feet, hands. Halfway, and fold. Chair, bend your knees, lower your hips, lower yourself right down, boat pose.
This is for the girls that don't need no makeup.
I don't know what's going on with my hair. It's all coming out of my pony. All these little pieces. Use this opportunity to fix that. Knees to triceps, knees apart, feet together. You're in a seated crow pose. Pull your feet down toward your sitting bones. Scoop your belly back. Good. Right foot stays in, left leg goes out. Down to Shavasana, come forward. Inhale, rise up. Come back into that crow pose, boat pose, seated crow. And then right leg out, left foot in. Come forward, Janu Shavasana.
Shake it, baby, like I know you can. So many things in this world, I don't
Rise up, please. Okay, I'm gonna turn toward you. Same thing, but instead of knees on triceps, bring your knees to your, like, the outer part of your upper arm. Good. Bring your palms together. Press your palms together. Take one leg out. Good. If you can, point your toe and, like, send energy out that leg. Yes. Mm-hmm. Don't stop. Last two. Cross at your shins. Make your way to downward facing dog. Get a nice big stretch on the front of the hips here. Yeah. And down dog. You really use your hip flexors and your quadriceps in that action of holding the legs up. Important to have that strength for arm balances. Right leg back, inhale. Right knee way up into that right arm, shoulder, tricep, elbow. Inhale back. And then exhale, cross. Inhale back. And then exhale, place your foot forward. Left hand stays down, right hand comes up. Nice big twist here. Use the back toes. So instead of just kind of sinking back and letting the heel drop back and getting that like dropping sensation, push the foot down and feel how that lifts your left thigh up. And then pull your feet toward each other. Mm-hmm. One more inhale. Right hand is going to come to the inside of the right foot, or your arm can be on your thigh. You can use a block here if you want. Back heel roots down. You're just going to unravel the twist and take it the other way, side angle. I don't think I've done this pose yet this week, which is why I think it feels so good right now. Straight in the front leg, open up to triangle. You can shift your hand right up onto your shin. You can use a block on the back of the right leg, or you can put your right hand lightly on the ground, lifting up. One more inhale, and then release your left hand all the way around. Pivot to the pinky side of your left foot and then open up Vashisthasana. Mm-hmm. Good. Option. Elbow and knee come together. And then your way to down dog. From dog, left leg back, inhale. Left knee, left arm, anywhere on that arm. Try to get a high. Inhale, up and back. And then exhale, cross over to the right. Inhale, back. And then exhale, place your foot forward. Keep your right hand down. Stay high in the back toes. Use the back foot. Pull the feet toward each other and then sweep the left arm up to the sky. Right hand, right arm gives your, like, your left arm energy. Start from the ground. Draw up, draw up, draw up across the chest, across the upper back. Keep pulling those feet toward each other. Feel all of your toes, all of them. One more breath in. Left arm to the left thigh, hand to the inside of the foot on a block on the ground, you choose. Side angle. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Pull the feet toward each other. Mm-hmm. Inhale, straighten up into triangle, your version. Mm-hmm. So nice. Good. Release this right hand down, pivot around to the pinky side of the right foot, Vashisthasana. And then option to bring the left knee and the left elbow together. That wasn't pretty. Now it is. And then your pathway to downward facing dog. Little pause. Rise high to your toes, inhale. Bend your knees, bring your feet to your hands. Halfway, inhale. Fold, exhale. Rise up to stand, inhale. Use your hips, sweep the arms to the sky. Forward fold again. Inhale, pull your heart forward. Stretch your left leg back, stretch your left leg back. Fold forward, standing splits. Bend your right knee, step your left leg back, left arm outside your right thigh. We twist. Use that back foot. Maybe you open up. Mm-hmm. Release the hand down, root the back heel. Side angle, any version. Inhale, Trikonasana. Exhale, release down. Left hand, left foot. Vashisthasana. Maybe this knee up. Maybe bring the arm to the knee. And then release it. Take your way to down dog. High onto your toes. Inhale. Bend your knees. Look where you're going. Feet to hands. Halfway. Inhale. Fold. Exhale. Rise all the way up, inhale, squeeze your butt, lift your heart, and then fold back down. Halfway, inhale, right leg stretches back in the air, and then melt down, standing splits. Bend the standing leg, step the right foot back, right arm outside left leg, your choice, what that looks like, use your feet, and then unravel that side angle. Yes. Triangle, open it up, and then releasing down. Vashisthasana, maybe with this knee up. And then through to down dog. Inhale, lift your heels. Bend your knees, malasana, feet wide. Things down. Yes. Good. Really work the arms inside the knees and the knees into the arms, into the shoulders. If you need your hands to do this, you're going to sit down and then try to pick up your feet. Keep this connection. Keep the hands together. See if you can straighten both legs out. Woo. Bring them back in. Both legs out. And in, and then take the arms out straight. Mm-hmm. A few more. Stay with it. You've got this. One more. Cross your shins. Make your way back to down dog. Inhale, right leg back and lengthen. Drop heavy into the left heel. Take a pause here. Stretch the arms a little longer. And then right knee to right shoulder, elbow, tricep. Inhale, slide your knee down to your wrist. exhale, pull it back up. Inhale it down. Exhale, glide it up. One more time, inhale down. Exhale it up, place your right foot outside your right hand and turn your right toes a little bit open. Your knee follows that line. Good. And then push into the feet, start to straighten the right leg any amount and see if you can lift the toes up off the ground. Good, rebend the front leg. Put your left knee down on the ground. Take your right hand to your right ankle. Drop the chest low. So take it from up here and drop it low. Bring your hand to your calf and see if you can get your shoulder inside of your knee. You don't need to go anywhere but here. And you might not get your shoulder inside, like underneath. It might just be to the inside of the knee, not like fully under. If you want to play, we're going to play. Bring your hands back a little bit. So behind the heel. And then lift your chest up. And in the action of lifting your chest up, your right heel might just pop off the ground. And then extend that leg out. And then maybe slide that left leg back, keep the toes down. And so you're working the framework of Kundinyasana 2, connected, either knee or the foot. And then when you're ready, back to down dog, with or without chaturanga. And then take a pause there. So we're just making shapes. I'm giving you options. It doesn't determine the value of your practice, whether you can lift off into an arm balance. Trust me when I say that. Left leg back, inhale. You're gonna stay here for a few breaths. Get heavy in that right leg, that right heel. Make the arms longer, make the spine longer. Take another breath in. And then left knee to left tricep, exhale. Inhale, glide the knee down. Exhale, pull it up. Inhale down. Exhale up. One more inhale. Exhale, and then place your left foot outside the left hand with your toes and your knee on a little bit of an angle. Work the back leg. Yeah, pull the feet toward each other. So just notice, especially on the front foot, as you push your foot down and pull it back toward the right leg, so left foot pushes down, pulls back toward the right foot, your hamstring starts to wake up more. Mm-hmm. Good, now keep that alertness in that left hamstring. Keep the feet pulling toward each other to start to straighten the legs out, and then lift the toes up if you can. So the hamstring is still engaged, even though we're lengthening it. You can kind of reach and touch. And then rebend the leg. Put your right knee down. And then take your left hand to your heel or your ankle. Drop your chest down. And then see if you can slide your shoulder first inside of the knee and then underneath it. And then bring your hands back a little bit. And then lift your chest up and look forward. So when you do that, if you've got the knee hooked over the shoulder, I'm gonna actually change my angle here, it pops the foot up, right? The heel up. And then turn the leg open and maybe slide that right leg back. But you don't have to. If you feel like you want to take it off the ground, go for it. But you're good wherever you are. Work chaturanga arms. And then back and through to down dog. And then pause in your breath. Inhale high into your toes. Bend your knees, look forward, feet to hands. Inhale and lengthen. Fold, exhale. Chair. Sink and sink and sink. And carefully sit down. Navasana. Mm-hmm. Good. So all these shapes that we make, they lend like to the next one. There's always a carryover, and it's our ability to find that carryover that helps us to kind of find some of these deeper poses. Bend your knees, take your feet, and then like happy baby, but you're seated. Good. And then use the legs, the power of the legs, the push of the feet forward into the hands to lift the chest, to broaden the collarbones, to pull the heart high. Good, you're gonna bring your right foot over toward your, left foot, lordy. Bring your left foot over toward your right sitting bone. Good, take both hands to this right foot. Good, good. Start to lift up, and now here's what I want. Don't straighten the leg all the way yet. You can hold your foot, you can hold your calf, you can hold a hamstring at the heel, but I want you to push your leg toward the ground. So you're not trying to straighten and pull in, I want you to push it away from you. Push the leg down, and in that action, lift the heart up. If you can, point the toes. Pretty sure you can. Uh-huh. Unless you're getting like a foot cramp or a calf cramp. Good. Start to bend the knee. Bring your right hand to the inside of your right leg and take the heel. Take the left heel and then come back up into like happy baby holding the heels. The arms are on the inside. Hands are on the inside of the heels. Push the feet forward to lift up. We're gonna do the same thing that we did on the first side. Bring that right foot over toward the left sitting bone. You see how well I did that? In my rights and lefts. And then start to take that leg forward, but don't straighten it quite yet. And just with a bend in the knee, kind of figure out like, how deep does this need to be? Like how far out do my hands need to be? And then start to push your leg toward the ground. Like you want to go into like Janushirshasana. Yeah? Push, push, push. Lift up. So now the hamstring lengthening, but working at the same time. Push, push, push. If your leg doesn't straighten all the way, I don't care. Like I really don't. Keep it bent if that feels better. Good. Bring your hand to your heel, left hand. Bend the knee, pick up the right. Bring the soles of the feet together. Now listen, hands come in front, knees pull up. I'm gonna turn toward you. Hands come in front, knees pull up. You're squeezing into your shoulders. So instead of taking your knees down, squeeze up. Draw the belly back. So I don't have my whole hand down. You might, I have fingertips down. For me, whole hand feels like, well, I guess I can do it. I can do it. See, sometimes you don't know you can do things until you try. It didn't feel like I could do it. It's there for me, but it might not be there. Fingertips are great. It's just the energy of the arms. That's what I'm looking for. Inhale, lift up, cross your shins, back to down dog, however you want to get there. So we've done all sorts of shapes, and yet we haven't done a full arm balance yet. You might have. You might have done Kundalini too when we took you there. But now we're gonna do those. Not all like one after another. If you can't access them today or any day, it doesn't matter. Just play, feel playful, pain-free. Inhale, right leg up and back. And then right foot outside of your right hand. Sink the hips down, lift the chest up, and then pull your left knee into your chest. Put your left foot down. Slide your right shoulder inside of your knee. Good. Bring your hands back. You're not going anywhere quite yet. Just lift that right leg up. So it's like, balance like crazy. Yeah. Good, rebend that right leg, slide your knee into your tricep. Bring your left knee onto your tricep, crow. Mm-hmm. Crow can also be done here with the toes down and just finding the shape. And you know I say this all the time, it's physics. You've got to take the chest forward to get the butt up. And then once the butt comes up, maybe you start to pull the chest forward, lift the gaze, and then take it back to down dog with or without chaturanga vinyasa. And then left leg stretches back, inhale. Step your left foot outside of your left hand. And then bring your right foot in. Right knee is centered at your chest. Good. You're up on the right toes. Shift forward, take that left leg out. Yeah. So stay there. Even if you can't access arm balances, right now you're doing an arm balance. Feel how much core is required to take that leg out. In some ways, I think this is actually much, much harder. Good, bring that left leg back. Knees slide up, crow. So the reason I'm taking you first into crow is it's the most familiar arm balance. And most of us feel like, hello, old friend, I can do you, or at least I know what I'm in for. And then make your way back to down dog. Take a few breaths, just let that kind of settle in your system. Right leg back, inhale. Right foot between your hands. Warrior three, just lift off. Both hands down. Left knee onto your left tricep. Right knee is at your chest. And just see if you can pick up the foot. Take the right leg back and then make your way to down dog. Just little tastes. Left leg back, inhale. Place your foot forward. Warrior three. Release your hands down. Right knee onto your right shoulder, tricep. Good, come onto the left toes. Maybe just take the foot up, step it back, and then make your way through. Mm-hmm. Right leg back, inhale. Right foot outside your right hand. Back knee, left knee comes down. Good. Take a little pause here. Work the arms strong. Hug the right knee into the right shoulder. Step the left toes. Pick up the knee. Bring the foot in closer. Left knee comes onto your left. It doesn't have to be right on the tricep. I would actually prefer it kind of being out a little bit on the outer part of the arm so you have a little bit more surface area for support. Good. And then from here, drop your butt down. Good. Pick up your right leg. And then tip forward, drop your chest down. Bring the feet together, take it back, make your way to down dog. Good. So it's all physics. It's how do we tip our body to get one part free to come up and then maybe another part needs to come free on the other side with this kind of wonky, uneven crow two. Left leg stretches back. Left foot outside your left hand. Right knee comes down and just pause. Work the arms, work the shoulder and knee against each other. Tuck the back toes, bring the right foot in closer. Bring your right knee kind of to the tricep or to the outside of that upper arm shoulder area. Good. Drop your butt down. So I'm actually sitting my right hip toward my right heel. That gives me the space, I'm gonna actually slide my hands back a little bit, to pick up my left leg. You need that space. And then you tip forward and you pick up the right foot or not. And then maybe to crow. And then take it back. Make your way through. Right leg back, inhale. Right foot outside your right hand. Back knee down. Good. Little longer stance this time. This is your last kind of round in case you're feeling like this was a lot. If you're feeling like, I just want to get started, you can do it a little faster, get more in. Walk your hands back. Straighten the right leg a little bit. Just a little bit. So kind of push out of that deep knee bend. Work the shoulder inside. Good. You can create a little bit more help using that hand. Hands are behind the front heel. Lift up. Good. Walk the foot out. Kind of turn it open. Think chaturanga. And then float it. Or not. Take it back. Down dog. With or without chaturanga.
Yeah, I just Good. Kept dreaming. It wasn't very hard.
Yeah, yes. Left leg back, inhale. Left foot outside the left hand. Right knee down, a little longer stance.
Trying to figure out why. Nobody on my side.
And then start to push out of that deep bend in the left leg. Work the left shoulder inside. Hands come behind that heel. So start to lift the chest, look forward, tuck the back toes, and then lift. Make your way back. Down dog. Heels up, knees bend, malasana. Out wide. Yes, bring your hands up. Circle those wrists. Lace your hands. Circle them again. Mm-hmm. Forward fold. Keep the feet wide. Hold the elbows. Drop the head.
Going and hoping I'm growing near. Well, that's good and fine. I spent all this time trying to find my way here. And I've been having me a real fun time.
Bend your knees. Come all the way down onto your back. Come all the way down onto your back. Doesn't have to be fancy to get there. Just get there. In case you have to leave early, I'm going to pose a question for you. You don't have to respond to me yet. I will not be able to teach next Wednesday. If you would like me to teach yoga on Monday to replace the Wednesday class, let me know. If you don't, you don't have to say a word. I'm only going to go from yeses. Bridge pose. Push your feet down. Lift up. Release it down. Same bridge, upward facing bow, you choose, rise up. One more breath in and release up. Take the feedback. What do you need next? One more bridge or upward facing bow. Maybe you don't need a back bend. Maybe you just lay and breathe. Release down and legs out straight. Arms at your side, take a pause. So now that was a lot in your hands, a lot on your wrists. If you feel like it wasn't and you want to get upside down into a handstand, you have that option now. Headstand, forearm balance, shoulder stand. Simply stay here and breathe. Take your legs up to the sky or any pose that you feel like you need that we did not do. We still have a few more seated poses and stuff, but. You only have about a minute here, it's not long. My house is being cleaned right now if you hear a ruckus. I'd like to say I'm sorry, but I'm not. It really needs it. Good. Come to seated when you're ready. Left foot comes toward your right sitting bone. We've been here. Right leg extends out. Good. This is perfect. Maybe reach across. Maybe bend the knee. And then maybe open up. Good. Maybe bend the knee, tip forward, and come into Kundalini 2 again. And then come back out the same way you came in. What? Yes. And then bring that leg across, double pigeon, or any seated comfortable position like this to get into the hips and come forward. Rise up. Good. Bring your right foot over toward your left sitting bone. Take your left leg. You don't have to straighten this leg. I want to be clear about that. I didn't say it on the first slide, but I hope you know that by now, right? You're just doing what you got. Good. This is perfect. Maybe reach across. Maybe open up. Good. Maybe stay there or maybe tip it forward. Kundalini 2. And then back out the same way you came in. Woo! And then double pigeon or cross-legged, whatever works for you. Okay, stay there and breathe. Can you wait 5? See the black heels around the fire. Feel the light and perfect darkness, baby. Perfect darkness is all I can see. Deep water, stay under. Feel it going over your head. Just roll with it until it's up with you. Beautiful. Rise up. Take both feet. Legs don't have to straighten. Release the legs, control them down. Bend the knees a little bit. So I don't know if you can see my black on black here, so I'm gonna really exaggerate it. Bend the knees, pull the heels in toward your hips. Good, wake up the hamstrings. Keep that connection. Keep pushing the heels down and start to press out. Good, and then maybe come forward, but maybe not. Keep that connection, so keep that drawing back with the heels. Mm-hmm. Press down to rise up. Use the legs. So good. If you want to stay seated to finish your practice seated, cross at the shins or sit in Siddhasana like this. Take a twist. If you want to go into Shavasana, lie down, you'll take a twist there. So it's your choice how you want to finish. You can also finish legs up the wall. And then gently reverse the twist. Release through center. Good. Set yourself up. Lying down, sitting up, you choose. If you're sitting and you need something under your hips, grab a block. If you're lying down and you need to put something behind your knees or if you need to bend your knees, just kind of set it up so that you're in a place where it's a very short time of stillness, but we're not just being still because we're not doing anything. We're choosing stillness. So choosing stillness, setting it up. Start to deepen the breath. If you're lying down, start to wake up your hands and your feet. from lying down, bend your knees, roll to your side, and then gently rising up. Once you're seated, just let your hands rest on your thighs. In this last moment of your practice, just sort of running it back like a movie, like what were you capable of doing today? What challenged you? What frustrated you? What felt really good? And embracing all of those things. And we made choices. We place our body in a specific way in this practice. We place our thoughts in a specific way. We place our breath in a specific way. And that's indicative of how we end the practice, choosing either Shavasana, seated meditation. We're placing ourselves in that final pose. And we practice it the same way we place ourselves in Warrior One and practice that. So there's no hierarchy to postures. Bring your hands together at your heart. Lift with an inhale. Exhale, bow your mind to your heart. You're amazing. I thank you always for being here. Thanks, you guys. Oh, Lulu's coming in at the last second. She's been sitting over there watching me. Oh, Lulu, say hello to everyone. Mwah. She's like a plus size model, y'all. She's so pretty, but she's a big girl. She is a big girl and proud. We're proud of her girth. Thank you, Miss Mary.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
She's like a little stuffed animal. You see,
she's great.
Beautiful.